G'day mates, and welcome to Divinity Original Sin 2. Now, we played the old one a while back with a certain someone who is here again to help us go through the second game.
Hey, hello.
How dare you interrupt me? How dare you? I was going to give
you all
your
honours. I wasn't sure whether you were going to introduce me or whether I was going to have to introduce myself.
How dare you? You know, here I was trying to give you your honours.
Anyway, I'm back. Thought you'd gotten rid of me.
Yes, I had. So Scott is here to help me play through the game. And you love this one because it's now got dwarves in it, don't you?
Yeah, yes.
Well, without further ado, let's dive in. Alrighty then. That was one hell of... That was a bloody adventure. So, welcome to character creation. Now, up the top left... Sorry, top right, you're going to want to screw with Origin. Because you can play as one of the three or four... Four default characters, right? But I'm going to go custom. The default characters have, like... Now, there's a sort of a new system the way it works. Do you see the bottom right? There's tags. They basically show how you react to something. So you can be a soldier noble, you can be a barbarian thief, you can be a all that stuff, and it changes how you react to the world, right?
Oh, cool.
However, yeah. The characters like Iphan, Lois, and all that, and the Red Prince, they have specific reactions that are character only. But I'm just going to make a custom character and just roll with
that. Yeah, I'm going to make a custom character too.
Alright, so I'm going to be Rimmy. So, actually, no, fuck it. I'm going to go Keelbrathen, because that's an awesome name. Oh, god damn it. I'm just going to call myself Keel. Done. No, I'm not done with creating my character. Right, I'm going to be a human. Now, fun fact about the dwarves. You guys get Metamorph, which is a power where you just turn someone into stone.
How about that?
Yeah, you also get Sturdy, which boosts strength by 2 and gives you +1 in sneaking. So that's nice.
Cool.
Yeah. I am smart, and I get leadership as well.
Yeah, cool. I'm accepting.
All right, let's do this.
Yes, I am done with my character.
All right, here comes the intro.
Honorable Dallas, madam. We lost a ship sailing sorcerer prisoners to Fort Joy. We assume some escaped and brought their colors. Their vow magic lured in Voidwalking. All who were aboard... the presumed dead. Yours faithfully, into eternity. High Judge Orivand.
Okay, nice voice acting.
I know. So, last game we were actually Source Hunters, which means we eradicated Source, which is basically just evil magic, and now we're actually Source Afflicted. We are people with Source.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm not really sure, like, what the ending to the... Because we never finished the first game. I loved it, but we always ended up restarting it for one reason or another.
Yeah.
The Enhanced Edition was really good fun, though. Like, it made the game way better. But, yeah, this game apparently is really nice. A few things that are cool as well is if you sneak up on people, you can hear conversations that they wouldn't say if you were there. And all that sort of cool stuff. Okay. There's a lot of that really cool interaction. But nice. I can't wait to see what's going on in this. But yeah, do you see the loading screen? There's a dwarf being caressed in the bottom left. Look at that.
You're right. By the lizard dude, yeah.
I love you. Toss me. Don't I live.
Two towers were erected that night.
Alrighty.
Oh, that's you.
Yeah, I'm in.
I'll read out your lines because you're... did you see them? The void are working. They made short, bloody work of their ship. And there's no telling if they're through with us yet. Hey, you awake? So, we are both Source muted, because look at these fancy fucking collars we got on. Also, holy shit, your guy looks amazing. He looks like Junkrat if he was a dwarf.
Haha, yeah.
This guy, I look like I have a bathrobe on. It looks like just too short.
Yeah. Okay.
Alright, let's keep a job going.
I like your little... character picture up in the top left-hand corner.
Oh my god, yeah, look at my beard. I love that bloody moustache. Nice. Right. This is an ancient statue of Brachius Rex. I thought the Order would get rid of all the any trace of the old Source King, eradication and all. So pretty much the Order eradicated, like they're trying to eradicate Source. Oh,
yeah.
What is this shit? Look at this little guy. Who's this one?
Where?
There's a narrator. Do you want to do the narrator? We can like switch between.
Yeah, sure. I'll start.
All right.
The child has a small mirror in his hands. He holds it up at angles, inspecting his eyes, his chin, the crown of his head. He spots you, and his arms snap to his side.
I'm not supposed to talk to strangers.
I'm gonna human tell him not to worry. He can trust you because I'm a human. I can say this.
Oh yeah.
Why?
Tell him that everyone's got to stick to their own. What should I do? Say you wouldn't harm him. I'm gonna say I won't hurt you.
But. Are you a sorcerer? One of the bad guys that brings the bad void things here.
I'm gonna nod. I am. And by the looks of that collar around the neck, so is he. There you go.
The child looks at you straight on, unafraid, searching your face. He lifts his mirror to his nose, closes one eye and looks at himself again.
I don't see any sauce on you or me. I guess they're just wrong or crazy.
tell them they may be well wrong and crazy. Yeah. Or I'm going to tell the child... I'm going to ask him why he's out here alone. Yeah.
Mm. No one cares where I go. They know I can't leave the island. It's nicer out here anyway.
Say it isn't safe. Your ship was attacked by Void Awoken, not far off the shore.
I saw. I guess a lot of people died. But you didn't.
I'm gonna ask him... I'm gonna tell him to go somewhere safe.
There isn't anywhere safer. That's what I mean. You'll see.
Alright, we're gonna murder... we're killing this kid.
okay.
I'm gonna ask him why he doesn't seem scared.
I guess I am. But it's just normal to be scared, you know? Nowhere isn't scary.
Where are your parents?
Oh, they're gone now. The Magisters took them already. I guess they're cured. And maybe they're waiting for me back home. Oh.
Take your leave. Alright, Scott, yeah. How do we draw weapons? I've already forgotten.
How do I get out of this? Is it that one? Yes, it is. Okay, I'm here. Hello, little kid. How are you?
I love how you shuffle around. You're like,
yeah, the way it walks.
God.
Where did we go?
Oh, your name's Rodan the Stout. That's great. Yep. How do I draw
this? This is what Rodan the Stout went through. This is the story of Rodan the Stout before.
Rodan the Stout. Didn't he die before what? The first game?
How did he die? He died very quickly. Goblins.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, you got betrayed and stabbed by goblins. I forgot that.
Yep. But this is what happened before. This is like a prequel to his life. And that's why I made him dies a paladin. In this. to goblins. It's like, how did he... wait, what? Oh, well, this doesn't have to be canon.
I'm trying to figure out, how do you draw weapons? Because that was always a fun thing. Oh, this works.
Oh. Okay. What have I got?
I don't know. I'll try not to hang on.
I've got a couple of holy hand grenades.
Are you kidding me? What?
I know. The holy hand grenade will significantly heal everyone in a 5-meter radius.
That's oh my god, that's amazing. Right. Oh, hang on. Still got that moused over. Here we are.
And I have a resurrection scroll.
Come on then. Let's go on an adventure.
Oh
boy.
I think it might be this way because it auto-saved.
Yep.
Where'd you go?
Voidwoken. Those same beasts that sunk our ship. Damn, they made it to shore. Okay, so left shift to visualize the enemy's sight range. What is that thing? The fuck? Look at those.
Whoa, it's a viscous voidling.
All right, let's do it. Let's have a bash. Also, I think it might be like... control or hold alt might actually do it. Rightio, so I go first because I've got awesome super high initiative. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to ricochet this shit. Watch this, ready? Booyah!
Oh, okay, you just killed them both.
No, I did a fair bit of damage.
Oh, no, you didn't? Oh, okay.
Now, I've got a second action. I'm actually just going to... I can't ricochet just yet. I'm going to... Oh, I'll just shoot him. Here we are. Yeah, Archer Seema. What the fuck? You!
Ah, he knows me!
I know you!
Okay. Combat in Divinity Original Sin 2 is played in rounds. Everything you do in combat. Alright, cool.
You don't have to
understood.
Read it.
Understood.
Oh,
I understand.
I understand.
I understand that as well. I understand that too.
We need to figure out how to sneak again. Oh, dude, there's a crafting panel. This looks awesome. You can, like, experiment and you can do, like, recipes and shit. That's so cool. Oh, he bopped me. It's all good. I can actually fire twice a turn, so I'm just going to kill this one. And, Hang on. I can kill that one probably. Here we are. There we are. Nice, so you finish this one off.
Alright. Wait, yeah, you did kill that one.
Yep, that's why I was making sure. Oh, you got diseased.
Okay.
Oh, hang on, we get to have a chat. Here we are. Grimace at the dead wait, hang on, what? I think the narrator's like shipped in for himself right now, like there's gonna be voice acting. Okay, whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Grimace at the dead creatures and suggest that these... Oh, okay, I think I know what this is meant to be. I think that the narrator, whenever they're in, like, the asterisks, you're meant to just voice your character. It's like, these must have been what attacked our ship. Like, that's what it's meant to be.
Oh, okay.
It's very, very confusing to actually just read it out. You have to read it first and then say what it says. Anyway, so there you go.
Yeah, okay, so what do I want to say?
Who
said that?
Well, say
nod
it.
And say good riddance.
No, you don't nod and say good riddance. You actually say that. Like you say, a lot of people died because of these things.
Good riddance.
Yes, there we go. They didn't put up much of a fight. Dry land mustn't suit them.
Ha ha ha.
Hurry, hurry. Let's loot them.
Banter.
Oh, yeah. God, there's nothing on them. Right. Oh, hello, there's a magister over here. Look at this. Drowned and eaten by a void worken. I wonder which happened in what order. Oh my god, there's a resurrection scroll.
Damn it. You're already looting up. Well, I'm going to loot here. There's nothing in there.
I got an apple and a healing potion.
Yeah, that's nothing.
Hang on, we got to remember how to... Okay, so, by the way, control is how you attack something, if you want to, like, just straight up attack something.
I
can't remember how to sneak. Oh, C is sneaking. The best thing about... Look at my face! Holy fuck! Oh my god! I'm a barrel. Yeah, press S. Oh, sorry, C. Sorry, not S. I'm a fucking idiot. You're a fucking rock! Holy fuck! I'm a barrel. This game is great.
Look, I blend right in.
Fuck, alright, where are we going?
Actually, yeah, that's pretty cool.
We should go down. Fuck, I love this game. Oh, also, don't forget, you can walk up to something. Is it hold control? Is it hold alt? Yeah, here we go. Also, if you hold alt, you can see all the things, like a shell, and you can toss crates. There seems to be a fight over here. If you hold shift, you can see the enemy's range. See, that's where a fight will start. So,
nice.
Doo-doo. Doo-doo.
Should we sink?
Doo-doo, doo-doo. Right. Oh, hang on a second. There's a guy over here. It's the Red Prince. This is one of the characters you can play as. I'm gonna go say hi. You spot a strange lizard gazing over the water with a steady, malcontent stare. His skin is of a bright, blood-red color. Never before have you seen a lizard such as his. I can make fun of his skin, gleefully sneak up on him with the intention of pushing him into the sea.
Oh, he's noticed, I think.
Oh, God. Just as you're about to push your hands into his back, the lizard turns with feline agility and you see a flash of claws. Next thing you know, you're on your back, blood dripping from the gashes along your cheeks.
Damn.
Doesn't do to sneak up on someone downwind, manling. Especially when you smell like a rotten kipper. The lizard reaches for your arms and with remarkable strength help you back on your feet. I suppose now that I've drawn your blood and blemished your honor, you'll want restitution. To the death then? I'm ready.
This may be a bad choice. I don't think we should fight him.
I can literally murder him right here, right now. No, I'm going to say, hold your horses, mate. Come on, come on. Let's just be mates. Indeed. That makes you a would-be backstabber and an honorless specimen both, which is only to be expected.
Damn.
Let's tell him there's no honor in killing. I beg to differ. I like he's basically the Emperor. Execute Order 66.
Oh, God.
Find the rebels.
Find the rebel scum. Right. Okay, so I like the color of your skin, mate. That's because I'm the only one. They call me the Red Prince, the spouse of the sun. They say when I was born, the sun didn't set for 7 days, so enamored was she with little red me. Be that as it may, I fancy I was rather lucky to be born a prince. It made them celebrate my uniqueness. Had I been common born, they might have drowned me in a well. I'm going to ask if you'd ever considered looking for companionship. No. Wonder if it's a search of solitude that brings him here by the sea.
If it was, I failed, didn't I? But no, that wasn't the true reason. I don't know why I would ever tell you this, but at this precise, this defining moment in time, I'm quite beyond the vanities that would otherwise impede me. I find my mind wandering along the wall-like frontier of suicide, you see. To scale it, or not to scale it, that is my conundrum.
He wants to just off himself, poor lizard.
I know, right?
Remark that you could... I can always lend a hand, should courage fail you.
Like, hang on, fuck, no! Fuck, no!
Good job.
Hang on,
that's not what you meant.
I thought lend a hand as in help him not kill himself. That means help him kill himself.
No, I don't want to off Mr. Red Lizard. Oops.
That would be hardly fair now, would it? The operative notion in suicide is that it is self after all. Besides, courage never fails me. Weakness does not belong to the characteristics of a prince.
True courage would mean that you brave the misfortunes that assail you. Why don't you join me? You intend to escape from this isle, no?
Escape? I had not considered this option. Being neither avian nor amphibian in nature, aren't you literally amphibian?
Yeah, isn't he a lizard guy?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Is he a lizard?
Or,
he looked like a lizard.
Lizards aren't amphibian, are they? Or are they just like water? Or are they?
No, you're right. I don't think they are amphibian.
Weird,
no.
Whatever.
Right.
The prospect would please me, I admit. My alternative would be rather dour. But tell me, why would I cast in my lot with you? Humans make for good house elves. So it's slaves. Honestly, same thing. Not comrade in arms.
Damn it, you should have talked to him. He'd probably be like, dwarves are so lovely. Oh, I caress them all the time. Did you see? Ah, there's even a photo of me. I'll make it back home or die trying. If you stick with me, you'll have that chance too.
Home. I do not think there's any such a thing. Yet, to see, perhaps to touch, if for one final time.
The lizard's eyes, soft as a sea just a moment ago, turned to stone. Cold, determined, unyielding.
Home, you've convinced me. Let's go.
Hey!
Yes! I dibs Lizard Man because I voice him.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. All right, so I could chain him to you. There we go. And I could chain him me. There we go. That's really cool. We already got another party member. Look at how he runs. He's got that little weird, like, lizard run. Oh shit!
I'm actually... when I am way slower than you.
Yeah, that's quite
just
amusing.
For being a dwarf.
Oh, what the shit! Oh, I can talk to that cat. First off, if you press home, you'll lock back onto to looking at your character. I'm gonna talk to the cat.
Oh yeah.
Okay. The cat's eyes are clouded and grey, but it stares at you with acute intensity.
What? How did I? Hey, stop following me.
Insist that you aren't following it. It approached you. Ask the cat if it's feeling okay. Cat, are you alright?
Yes, I'm fine. I'm absolutely fine. I'm just... It's all a bit foggy.
Where did you come from, cat? The cat opens its mouth as if to speak, but his eyes lose focus, and with a jerk, he turns away from you.
What the shit, cat?
Fuck you, cat.
And starts licking himself.
Alright, where do we want to go? Ooh, can we
go
up
here?
Oh,
he's following us.
Oh my god, what? Oh my god, we have a cat, yes! Oh shit. Scott, I would like to point out, look at the HP of that sleeping bag.
Which bag?
The sleeping bag, look at it.
Oh yeah.
Look at the HP.
The bedroll.
Ooh, no, the sleeping bag. Look at the HP of the sleeping bag, my good man.
Oh wow, oh god, I just...
Yeah.
Oh my.
What's in this thing? I found... Hang on a second, I found tomato sauce... in a sack. Oh, hang on. Let me lie down. Hang on. Look, see if you can lie down. I'll try and get the red prince in on this action. Not enough space.
Not enough space.
But I could always make some room. Oh yeah, pressing home will lock you back onto your character.
Yeah, I've done that.
Rightio, let's go on a bloody adventure. Where are we even going?
Who knows?
You got the cat following you. It's adorable.
I think I do. Yeah, I do.
Hang on a second. Tension people feel to... Whoa, what's this? Whoa, hang on a second.
I
hold on real
dude.
Quick. Yeah, I've been surrounded. Hold on real quick. Look at this. See under the map? There's a thing called tension, which increases as people see you commit crimes, and it's basically like, did they just talk to you?
No, not
they,
yet.
They just rocked up and then buggered off, I guess.
No, I...
He's just run away. What the shit?
Where'd he go? What was he doing?
I don't know. They just rocked up and then run away. But yeah, there's like, there's a GTA crime system, right? You know, you increase tension as the game goes on. Hang on. How do I... Oh, come on. I need to get over the rock so I stop clicking on the rock. Where did that magister go?
I don't know.
I think they just disappeared.
Why am I going that way? Go the other way.
Alright, tell you what. Tell you what, meet me at this, like, what looks like an actual building. Also, how the hell do you rotate the camera?
I don't know. I'll tell you if I know.
Oh, middle mouse. Right.
Is it?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. That's how you zoom in.
No, hold middle mouse.
I mean clicking.
Yeah. Alright, are you near me? You got your cat with you?
Yeah.
Oh, the cat stopped. Whoa, shit. What the fuck? Yeah, I'll wait for you to catch up. I'll voice her. Stay back, you. It's basically Justinia. Huh. Stay back, you, and stay silent. Your savior is speaking. Your turn.
Who's this? Magister Atusa.
Yeah, he's a lizardman.
Is this a female or a male?
I think it's a male.
I can't see.
Yeah.
Come, Alexander. I sooner cut my tongue than lie to you. I know nothing of this Verdus.
Then do it. If you can tell his holiness no more, then your tongue is of no use. Cut it out.
This can't be serious. Alexander, come.
Oh my, tags. Oh yeah, I can use my tags.
Huh, cool.
You will address me with the proper honorifics, Magister, and you will obey your superior, whatever she ask.
Is Alexander or is she? I think Alexander might be.
No, she has got a beard.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, hold on. So I've now got a choice. Wonder aloud why they bother. A tongue can't be harder to grow back than a tail. What the fuck?
Whoops. I just walked a bit close.
Yeah, those weird, like, ghoul Slenderman things attacked you.
Yeah.
I'm going to say rogue. If they want information, gold would be by more than torture. That's what I think, at least. Atusa pinches the tip of her tongue with two fingers and brings her dagger to its root. What?
Oh.
Her eyes squeeze shut, drops of blood form against the dagger's edge and quickly fall to the ground. She groans. Stop. Dallas, I believe you made your point. My father, may his soul rest in peace, would be disappointed in you, Atusa. To think you would lie to his only son, your bishop and your friend all these years. Your bishop and your friend who only wish to save the realm from destruction. Dallas? Yes, your holiness? We are done here. What the... What the fuck? Whoa! Someone just got melted. Oh, Jesus Christ. Poor red lizard just got thrown in his ass. Hey, if we look, there's apparently a log you can look at.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
I witnessed the death of a magister and all that stuff. Hey, let's have a chat. The lizard magister, or what's left of her, lies in a puddle of her own gore.
There's one magister fewer for us to worry about, then.
So much for the divine order compassion. Oh, look, yeah, the red prince has got something to say. So... To die at the hands of a human is insulting and unjust, no matter what your house. I will have blood for her blood. Yep, there we go. That was the Red Prince.
Alrighty.
Let's loot her corpse. Oh my god, and okay, you take this resurrection scroll. I'm just gonna take her leg. I've got a Molotov and her leg.
Wow.
Yes, this game is great. Coming soon, party dialogues. Sadly enough, that's not in the game yet. Ah, well. You got the resurrection scroll?
Did you throw it on the ground?
Oh, no, it's on the corpse.
Oh, you left in there.
Yeah.
Okay,
yep.
Cool. Yep. Mm, got it.
Hey, F5 to quick save.
Cool. Fort Joy Ghetto.
Oh, we can barter. Hang on. Saw him, didn't ya? The Hammer and Alexander. Ha! They really gave that scaly traitor what for they did. My doctor gave me an ointment for scaly buggers. Worked like a charm. Wish it was that simple, just be rhythm, I do. Yeah, these are the type of buggers you gotta flint off with a knife, I'm afraid. When will I be allowed to leave this place? When you give up the darkness that's inside you. Tain't your fault it's in their mind, but it's all the same. They're working on a cure for you now, even. Got some good leads, I hear, yeah? You can trust Dallas to take care of it. Once you're cured, your life will start again. Alright. So that's lovely.
Cool.
Where are we actually meant to... Okay, hang on. Let's look at our log real quick. What are we meant to be doing? We're bound by a collar that we need to be removed, and... There's just shit going on in Fort Joy. I'm gonna go talk to a guy. Farah, Jeth, all these people.
Oh, please. Please, you have to help me. No one here will. None of these bastards. A child is missing. My baby.
Okay. What is the child's name?
Irma. She's called Irma, she is. I hadn't seen her for days. I'm sick with worry. Oh, completely sick. And no one else in this damn camp will lift a finger to help me find her.
What happened with her disappearance?
I last saw her just here near 3 days ago. She was playing with a little doll and I was washing out her tunic. I turned for her one moment and then she was gone. Left a doll behind too. It's so unlike her.
Asked to have a closer look at the doll.
Yes, of course. You should take it with you. When you find her, give her the doll and tell her, Mama says this is for her little chicken. It's time to come home. You hear? Oh, that's what I call her, my little chicken.
She soaks up a steady stream of tears with her shirt sleeve.
She ought to come with you then. She ought to follow you back to me.
Wonder why no one else in this camp... I wonder why no one else will help.
Oh, this place turns people cold, cold and wicked. That fella Jeth over there speaks unutterable evil, but I can't move away from him. What if Irma comes back and I'm not here?
I'll do my best.
You are an angel, good sir. You truly are.
Alright, you want to talk to Jeth?
Where's Jeth? Down here?
Oh, no, he's right there. Right here.
Oh, there he is. Okay, yeah.
I'm going to have a quick chat to the cat, see if anything's updated.
Nah. This is Jeth.
A fella can't hear himself think with all these racket. Day and night she hollers after that child.
Continue.
You hear that, Farah? You gotta cut that out. What's happened to you? If you don't like it, maybe you should help her. Aye, she needs help, but none that I can give. Mad as a cuckoo, that one, and twice as loud. Well, why do you think she's mad? What else do you call hollering after a ghost? That child of hers she's shouting after has been dead and buried a month over, killed by a void woken back in our home village. Never even stepped foot in Fort Joy.
Okay, so apparently her child is actually dead.
Wow, yeah. Crazy. Welcome to this
game. And there ain't no amount of hollering that'll bring her back. Okay.
Here I was ready to mount like a fucking rescue party.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have a quick chat to her. Oh, I'm not giving up. Okay, right. So we can end the quest by telling her, yo, your daughter's fucking dead. But let's have a look around first.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh. You can voice this one. He's quite a foppy mage.
Where are we looking?
Gavin. Gawain, sorry.
Oh, there he is.
You there. You've just arrived, isn't that right? Are you quite alone?
I am.
In that case, listen up. You must think me mad to approach a stranger. But this camp is full of cowards, and I'm running out of time. Fast. Too fast. Way too fast.
What are you planning?
I've been here a long time. Longer than anyone else. People get taken sometimes. Some folks say they get cured. I don't know if I believe it, and I don't want to wait to find out. I have a way out of here. It won't be easy. And I need a partner. Just one.
Hmm.
Are you interested?
I'm sorry. I have companions to think about.
Hey! Noble, but after the magisters take you all, your nobility will have been for nothing. Good luck with your friends, though. Enjoy your last days in good company, won't you?
We should kill this man. Right.
Yeah, it's a bit of a...
Bit of a fop toffee.
Oh.
Oh my god! There's a fellow dwarf! Now. Also, chubfish. I just picked up a chubfish, and there's a place...
Well, I'm gonna talk to him. And I can use my dwarf and noble talks, so...
Oh, can you? Oh, nice.
Yeah. I've got different talks.
Yeah, compared to me. Yes. I put the bond... Oh, wait. You can talk to this dwarf over here. He'll probably like you. Ah, yeah. Remember, red stuff is, what's it called? Owned by other people. So you can't steal it. Well, you can, but you shouldn't. But, of course, we are just ridiculous criminals, so...
Okay, where have you gone?
I'm just over here. I'm just going to steal this spellbook real quick.
Oh, you're in there.
Oh, hang on a second. What? Ooh. This is really cool. So some crimes leave a crime scene, like murdering or stealing. Even though no one saw you commit the crime, they may stumble on the crime later and investigate your party. How cool is that?
That's pretty cool.
Right. Do you want to talk to this dwarf here?
Oh, yeah, sure.
I want to talk to Mira.
This guy, Laszlo.
Hey, come on, you know this one, don't ya? Grab a bottle of arrow.
You know the song, but can't remember the following line.
Oh, a right disgrace you are. Come on, you remember. Grab a bottle of arrow, fill it up to the brim. Stick your sorrows in the arrow and drown them till they swim.
That's so good.
So, yeah, he's a drunk
he's
dude.
The best. He should be in our party.
I love him.
Right, I'm going to talk this fop toffee over here. Oh, the woman is scrabbling at her throat as though she can hardly breathe. You are right. Don't touch me. You're too close. This collar, this place, it's squeezing the life out of me. I'm going to tell her
she shudders like an ice addict.
Going to tell her to squeeze back. I can't barely even catch my breath. How is this possible? One minute you're in the garden in the sun, and the next you're here, and they put this thing around your neck. Her hand moves to her throat. She seems to try to make space between her neck and the collar, but there's no space to be made. Poor lady.
Damn.
Tell you what, we should go and find a way out of here. We gotta find some shit to do. What's going on here? Oh, I found a little way through here. Oh, hello. What the fuck is Waltz doing? What's this shit? Look it up. Look at how you climb ladders. You climb the ladder. I want to see how you climb a ladder. That's great.
Oh, okay. I didn't even see that there was a ladder.
Yeah. Oh, you're doing a fucking front lip. That's great.
Nice.
Oh, I fucking love this. All right, I'm going to talk to Waltz. Hey, Freshy. What you heard about a crate of stolen supplies? And don't you lie to me now. Oh, she's a girl, sorry. Hey, Freshy, what you heard about a crate of stolen supplies, and don't you lie to me now. I can't help you, but I hope you have a great day. She seems to fight the smile that appears at the corner of her lips. Ah, nice. Git, will ya?
Nice.
She's great, hang on. She grins at the sight of you, but quickly puts on a hard face. Heard of anyone that might have taken Griff's supplies yet? I'd like to help you find the culprit. Ha, what do I need your help for, Freshy? By the look of you can find a bush in a brothel. I mean, in the 70s, maybe. If you don't waste my time, I've got a crate to find. We should go find her crate and then laugh at her.
Yeah.
Alright.
Now let's see how I get Ooh. Down ladders.
Oh, this camp boss Griff. What's this guy?
Oh, another backflip.
Griff is slowly, methodically, peeling the skin from a potato. As you approach, he looks up, setting the potato, but not the sharp little knife, down on the table. What? Are you in charge around here?
Who's asking?
I'm a kinsman, come looking guidance. He smirks and holds a little knife up to the light, watching it glint.
Oh, I'm listening.
I'm looking for a way out of this place.
Can't help you there. If I could, I wouldn't be here peeling goddamn potatoes.
Is there anything I can help you with? He points the tip of his blade at the grisly sight of the elf hunched over, clutching his knees in the cage.
Oh, I solve my own problems.
Oh, there's an elf being, like, cooked. Are you interested in trade?
Sure. Have a look.
Alright, so he sells a makeshift shield, he sells some arrows, he sells Griff's overpriced Dundrane, which is basically weed.
Where can I see this?
Oh, you have to go to talk to him in trade, but that's cool.
Nah, alright. Yep.
Right. Let's have a look around and see what else I can find. Someone called Noosey here. I know that will look well enough. You're about to pop, ain't you? Why don't you enter a match and let that some of that frustration out right away? I smell an opportunity. Please elaborate. Winning has its own rewards, if that's what you're after. Slip down the hatch and talk to Thorn. Put those greasy hands to work, of yours to work. So we can go have like a cage match? I'm up to... Yeah. Shut up, elf. This elf seems to be badly injured. Why is he being held here?
This clown caught him stealing from the kitchen. Well, I still won't say where he stashed my supplies. Sounded like someone you let off with a slap on the wrist.
What is he meant to have stolen?
Supplies. A crate of food, citrus in particular. He'll talk or he'll die quiet.
I'll find the stolen supplies, and you'll free Amro.
All I want is the supplies. Happy to let this clown die in a gutter instead of my kitchen. Bring back my cake crate and you've got yourself a deal.
Alright, so let's go find his crate then. But yeah, if you want, you could go, what's it called? Hang on a second, there's the human character. I found him. Like, we could probably recruit him, but I think we shouldn't. We should probably recruit someone cool, like a dog.
Yeah. They better have another dog in this.
Who's this? Oh, this is the elf character. No. You spot an elven woman of astonishing beauty. Her entire poise and being conjures in your mind the image of a polished diamond. Radiant, sumptuous, elegant, but cold too, and sharper than any knife. Her eyes are focused on a lizard some distance away, and you get the distinct feeling he's an unfortunate man about to be trapped in the gaze of this tigress. Decide...
What's a guy gotta do to earn a stare like that?
No sooner than the words have left your mouth and she grabs you, than she turns around and grabs you in a stranglehold.
I love you.
You soon feel the tip of a long needle being pushed a little ways into your neck. You caught me off guard. No one catches me off guard. Who are you? I'm just another human, a long way from home. I mean you no harm. You're not very far from home, I'm sure. This is the turf of the magistrates, and magistrates tend to be human, like you. A push, a pivot, and now you suddenly face her, needle still all too deeply embedded in the side of your throat. Despite the precarious of the situation, you notice one detail in her beauteous features that breaks the spell of perfection, a curiously shaped scar on her soft left cheek.
Say, how'd you get that scar?
Let me tell you a little story. Once upon a time, a lizard cut this living scar, into my cheek, so that with a melody he could control me like a puppet on a string. As a slave I was, until I outwitted my master. He's now quite, quite dead, and I'm quite, quite free to kill any lizard I like. Just like to point out, I'm not a lizard. She drives the deal deeper and whispers,
In truth, it does not matter in the least who you really are. You saw me mark my prey. You could warn him, save him, or kill him before I get my chance. That makes you a liability. That makes you needle feed. How about, instead of killing him, you could join me?
How amusing. I admit I had not seen that twist coming. I was certain the pitiful begging was about to begin. Make your case and do it quickly. Why should I join you?
We're planning our escape, and we need people with talents like yours.
Escape? Impossible.
Nothing's impossible.
A silly thing to say, but under the circumstances, perhaps a modicum of optimism is a moral duty.
Fine, Euron. I'll sheath my lust for lizard blood now. Although I can't promise the sheath will stay, should we manage to actually escape. With a casual flick of the wrist, she withdraws the needle from your neck and smiles as if you just decided to sit down for tea. You're not quite sure if you ever sleep soundly with her in any sort of proximity, but she's on your side.
If the cat decides at least for the moment.
Yeah, oh, okay. Is there a lizard down here? Hey, Stingtail the lizard. What? But I was... Please, tell me, why did you wake me? I was so close. So close. What the hell? Dude.
What?
You smell like oranges.
Are we talking to someone?
Yeah, Stingtail.
Oh.
Do you know why? Do you know why he smells like oranges?
Why?
Because he stole the fucking citrus. And you smell of burnt hair and barren dreams, but I have the good breeding not to mention it. Tell me, lizard, do you know anything of Griff's supplies? Supplies? You mean the oranges, I suppose. Though I guess Mr. Griff is more upset about the Dundranae than the citrus. What do you know about the supplies? It's all here, I'm afraid, on my person. You've found your thief, but I'm anything but one of those snivelling addicts you'll find creeping around the kitchen. I need to dream. I, above all others, it is my vocation, my responsibility, now more than ever. What do you mean? Dundranae, it makes you the master of all you see when you sleep. The dream is not the play actor, but the playwright. It may be hard for you to understand, but my kind, we dream for the greater good. What we can see can predict the truth, even shape the truth, but we need Dundranae to do it. Before I was caught, I was brought here. I saw a vision, the void woken, slain, the divinity restored. But just as I was about to see how it all happened, the magisters beat down my door. This is my last chance to find out the secret, find out how to save us all. So you see, I cannot give back the Dundranae, not only for myself, but for all of us. My dreams are my gift, and they may be my salvation, too. Okay, finesse, seduct, I'm going to seduce a lizard. Alright, Scott, welcome back. Our belly's now full of mead and food. I'm going to finesse seduction. baby. Griff's out for blood, but I'll protect your identity if you hand the Dundranae over to me. Persuasion success. Your stat seduction managed to outmatch your target's stat reason.
Nice.
Ah, blood. And it won't be long before he'll have it, with all his thugs lurking about. They'd stick me in their sleep if they do. Fine, fine, take the Dundranae. I'll find another way. Ah, somehow, I have to, for all our sakes.
Cool.
Hey, cool. So, the person the elf lady wanted to stick was actually a thief.
Okay.